a small club that has to hit when the ball is shot and hanging this game on the glass.
Great baseline elevation and jumper falls for Jade LaVille. First 2 points.
Don Plitzer-White has been here multiple times and took her South Dakota team to the Sweet 16 last year. Those guards, I'm telling you, 11 and Gray has already gotten to the paint twice.
Well, in combination with Pellington and Reese, the top two scorers for the Wildcats as we take a look at the Capital One starting lineups. Esmeri Martinez playing against her former teammates.
With the play of your bigs, Kate Reese, capable of getting a double-double, probably needs to have a double-double today in this game.
Clear path to the basket for Jayla Hemingway. Arizona trying to shake loose of a three-game losing streak coming into the tournament. Had an early quarterfinal exit of the Pac-12 tournament against UCLA, and Esmeri Martinez knocks down.
Tiffany, there's a lot to be said for a coach's confidence in this tournament, and she's extremely confident in her coaching ability to hang in this thing.
Here's Lauren Fields coming over from Oklahoma State, a second team all Pac-12, or excuse me, Big 12 selection from the Cowgirls. Kate Reese free throw line, jumper gets it to fall. And this is a group who is gritty, and as Coach Plitzer-White told us yesterday, they find a way, and that ends a 7-0 run for the Wildcats. Spraining that ankle in yesterday's practice, a tense moment momentarily, but kept on going, went back to the locker room, got worked on, and looking just fine after that jumper. Co-most improved player of the year. Finds Jade LaVille, and LaVille, boy, she has to be that X factor for Arizona.
A big-time athlete that really gets tremendous lift off the ground, shoots it at the highest point. A big fan of 30 and White.
Isis Bay with the top shot, and she says, count that one. Watson grabbing the rebound. She's got 3 points to go along with it, trying to look for a little bit more. Instead, finds good her action. Teammate Bay, and again, high-low.
Really good action off that.
This Arizona group coming over from Tucson out of the Pac-12. And again, nice assist there from Pellington to Fields. So much excitement on both sides, the men's and women's. That spin move by Pellington. And boy, she has been a star this year. Draws the contact and one. First head coaching job at Arizona 7 years ago.
And she should stay the all-time leading scorer as long as she's the head coach, because if anyone gets close, just put them on the bench. Right? Scoring, some balanced scoring. Move the ball well. And anyway, not a tremendous three-point threat from distance.
At Arizona, she may have very well
yeah.
taken down that record. Pellington trying to answer back the other way. Oh, my.
Two-point shots and only 5 threes, so she's a paint touch driving downhill.
They're even more dangerous if they can knock down the open shot. Fake from Lauren Fields, the take. Tough shot, no good, but the offensive rebound and put back from Kate Reese.
25 and wide, just an anchor. I watched her play when she's a sophomore in high school. Always has had a high motor.
She contested and defended that shot against Madison, and Pellington back the other way, the left hand.
You watch her ability to take a hit, hang in traffic, get fouled, can finish on both sides of the rim. Very difficult.
Oh, call the bank, it's open. It's Friday, just past noon for Jayla Hemingway, her second triple of the quarter.
On either side today to advance.
Paris Clark, McDonald's All-American, chasing her own shot over to another McDonald's All-American. First in program history, you mentioned. Inside to Esmeri Martinez, who checks back in the ball game.
West Virginia is an undersized team on the inside, and that high-low look, no ball pressure, a tough angle to seal off. There's the answer for West Virginia.
This Arizona group finished fifth in the Pac-12, and Shayna Pellington.
Stingy, fiery on the defensive end, very much like their head coach. Love it. Don't you? The elevation of her jump shot is just tremendous.
Took down a two seed.
Yeah, you just never know. Arizona, I had them earlier this year. I thought they were, and they are, tremendously talented, but just could not get it done yesterday.
They like to find points, and we'll see if it nets positive results.
Man, how
on this
quick
end.
Is that?
Yep.
When I saw that yesterday, I looked at you and said, uh-oh, this kid's a problem. Just that isolation for those guards. No reason for a ball screen, but they can win their one-on-one match. matchup, and Quinterly just did.
That bucket has West Virginia trailing by 7, but back up to 9. Watson trying to work in the lane and does so, get some points in the paint. 16 now for the Mountaineers. So is Jade LaVille from the baseline, just leaves it short though. Rebound, and here's Quinterly outrunning and finishing on the other end.
Tiffany, that is so good.
Arizona has led the entire way in this one. Elena Pueyo, and Pueyo is knocking down the 15-footer. Boy, I tell you, Pueyo, the reason why Madison Smith wasn't on the floor for that final 3.5 minutes, picked up her second foul. She was in foul trouble, but prior to that, they slowed her down. Jayla Hemingway has been the Batman and Robin. Saw that adversity for West Virginia. They hung in there with Madison Smith with early foul trouble. But as Mary Martinez says, I'm going to keep on doing what I've been doing now. Future WNBA Hall of Famers, absolutely hilarious.
Yeah, they
hoot those two.
Tremendous. Are they not together? And they will most likely be talking a lot about South Carolina in this tournament.
In their game today, coming up after this one against Norfolk State out of Mia. The fake, and there's Watson.
There's so many great memories. Oh, look at the strip and the rip by Quinterly.
What a way to answer and respond from J.J. Quinterly, the sophomore.
Always a threat around that ball. You cross it over, 11 and Gray will have it run to the other end.
There was a mismatch inside, but Kate Reese said, I had eyes for the basket.
Making an appearance, and man, the memories that are made right now. You'll never forget good three ball out of the corner.
Ball game after that make from Quinterly.
And 11 did it again.
The jumper from Gilbert. Gilbert with so much potential. The pull-up J from Quinterly. It was in rhythm, but won't go down. Numbers back the other way. And that one goes in for Kate Reese. Three lottery pick in the upcoming WNBA draft, at least that is what's projected.
She is a special talent, Diamond Miller, in our next ball game, Maryland and Holy Cross here. Keep setting the rules of how the game's going to be played. 25 in white has had a massive performance as well. Now 20 points on the afternoon for Kate Reese.
And largest lead of the ball game for the Wildcats as they continue to bear down as Mary Martinez with another block in this ball game. So continuing to impact on both ends of the floor, and then she wisely passes up the open three to find an even closer and higher percentage shot with Kate Reese.
Four different 1,000 point scorers. It's this end of the floor that they've got to stay locked in if they're gonna advance. Got a double on the day, and the easiest one you've had, you missed. But you've kept those West Virginia guards in check until right now. Smith with a knockdown three to keep game pressure on Arizona. And crazy things have happened. That would be a monster of an upset. What I like about Arizona, you see Pellington drive the ball. To me, my eyes go to teams in any tournament, men's or women's, that have older kids that have had marked success, and Arizona has them with number one and number 25.
Well, number one in Shayna Pellington, who makes back-to-back buckets in the mirror at this time of the year, right? And figuring out what matters most. And for Shayna Pellington and Kate Reese,
they just hammered that ball inside. They didn't become a finesse team and start shooting jump shots. They either drove it or passed it to the interior.
An identity of her Mountaineers.
She's going to recruit to her culture. She's going to recruit the kids. They're all about grinding and working and defensive-minded, bringing a little bit more offense to her roster. You know, but Dawn was tremendous at South Dakota.
14th NCAA tournament appearance, but it all comes to an end here in the first round against Arizona. 75-62, your final score. Adia Barnes and her group